The witches of Dathomir are most prominently seen in Star Wars: The Clone Wars. Mother Talzin and the other Night Sisters were able to practice a form of magic fueled by the dark side of the Force. But did you know that the witches of Dathomir were first introduced in Star Wars Legends? Today we'll be talking about the Legends history of the Night Sisters and how they inspired their canon incarnations. 600 years before the Battle of Yavin, a human Jedi Knight named Aaliyah was exiled by the Jedi Order to the planet Dathomir. When she arrived, she was surprised to find more humans exiled there. Dathomir had a long history with the Force, and it was even one of the planets whose inhabitants boarded the Tho'yor and helped begin the Jedi Order. It also held a Sith Academy around 1,000 years before the Battle of Yavin. By the time of Aaliyah's arrival, the humans there were second on the food chain under the native population of Rancors. Under her leadership, the female Dathomirian population enslaved the males, tamed the Rancors, and became Force-sensitive warriors. They followed the Book of Law, which contained their most important rule, never concede to evil. That makes enslaving half their population sound a little hypocritical, but I'm just gonna move on. Over time, the women split into various clans that developed their own individual beliefs and practices, but they were mostly peaceful with each other as their core traditions remained intact. Their use of the Force evolved into spells. Use of the dark side, or night spells, was punishable by exile. A group of exiled women banded together to become the Night Sisters. Shortly before the events of The Phantom Menace, Darth Sidious visited the planet, and he was approached by a Night Sister who begged him to take her newborn child away, saving him from a life of slavery. Sidious could sense power in the child and trained him as his apprentice, Darth Maul. 4 years after the Battle of Endor, the former Imperial Warlord Zinj set up his shipyards around the moon of Dathomir. Luke Skywalker, Han Solo, and Leia Organa assisted in liberating the planet from Zinj and the Night Sisters. From that point forward, Dathomir had a friendly relationship with the New Republic. Switching over to canon, most of that history was ignored well before Disney ever purchased Lucasfilm and brought on the shift to Legends. While the Witches of Dathomir still exist, it would appear that most, if not all of them, are Night Sisters, practicing magic powered by the dark side. Their power was strongest on their homeworld, so they rarely left the planet until they came under the leadership of Mother Talzin. She worked alongside Darth Sidious, who promised to teach her in the ways of the Sith, but instead took her son Maul from her, which rewrote Maul's Legends history completely. We have yet to learn the ancient history of the Night Sisters, but there are a number of similarities between the canon and Legends cultures of Dathomir. Their use of the Force is still manifested in spells, as we see on multiple occasions in the Clone Wars. The males, or Night Brothers, were still used as breeders and servants to the women. But this brings us to perhaps the biggest difference between canon and Legends. Neither the males nor the females are human in canon. They are near human. The Night Sisters are Dathomirian, and the Night Brothers are Dathomirian Zabraks. The story of the witches was also cut considerably in canon. Most of the Night Sisters were massacred on Dathomir during the Clone Wars, leaving very few survivors. Mother Talzin and Asajj Ventress both escaped death for a time, but were killed shortly after. A Night Sister altar housed some of their spirits until it was destroyed 18 years later. By the time of the Galactic Civil War, a Night Sister named Shellish was the only survivor of their kind. That's it for today. Which version of the Witches of Dathomir do you prefer? The human light side users of Legends or the Dathomirian dark side users of canon? Let me know in the comments. If you haven't already, please like this video, subscribe to the channel, follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and Facebook, and consider checking out my Patreon page. As always, thanks for watching, and may the Force be with you.